Welcome to La Crosse Central High School's 2020 graduation ceremony. At this time, we'd like to recognize the members of the La Crosse Board of Education and the district administration. Mr. Randy Nelson, Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Troy Harsey, Associate Superintendent, Ms. Stacy Everson, Director of Secondary Education, Ms. Laurie Cooper-Stoll, President of Board of Education, Ms. Dawn Comu, Board of Education, Mr. Juan Jimenez, Board of Education, Ms. Brenda Leahy, Board of Education, Mr. Pelly Lee, Board of Education, Mr. Jeff Meyer, Board of Education, Mr. Brad Corberg, Board of Education, Mr. Shondell Spivey, Board of Education, Mr. Keontae Turner, Board of Education, Mr. Troy McDonald, Principal, Mr. Jeff Axness, Vice Principal, Mr. Mark Ambrose, Dean of Students, Mr. Joe Barron, Activities Director, and I am Julia Gasper, Senior Class President.
Thank you, Principal McDonald, for inviting me to give this graduation speech. You know, I've been thinking a lot lately about how far back you and I go, almost 50 years, hiking on Granddad's Bluff as kids, and of course, our winless Lincoln Junior High football seasons together. In fact, let me tell you guys a quick story about old Troy McDonald. It was late in the fourth quarter of a crucial seventh grade football game. We were down a score, and Coach Pat Marsh called in a trick play. The quarterback would lateral the ball to me, the halfback, and I would roll right with the option of either keeping the ball and running it or throwing a pass to the tight end, your principal, Troy McDonald. After years of playing Nerf football together, it was destiny that he and I were being called upon to save the day. I ran into the huddle from the sidelines with the play, and everything went by the numbers, the snap, the lateral. I had the ball, and there was Troy racing down the sidelines wide open. I had visions of the perfect throw, like the Nerf football days in our backyard. And as I released the ball with seconds left on the clock, I felt sure Troy would catch it easily and waltz into the end zone. In reality, though, the ball landed about 20 yards shy of where it was supposed to be. He never had a chance. I, of course, was devastated, horribly embarrassed. And when Troy came back into the huddle, I told him how sorry I was. That was our big moment, and I blew it. And you know what he said? Don't worry about it. And that's pretty much Principal McDonald in a nutshell. Always kind, always supportive. We lost the game, were last in the school district, didn't score a single touchdown the entire season, but the fact is we gave it our all. So anyway, thanks for those great memories, Principal McDonald, and for this opportunity to greet the Central High School graduating class of 2020. Congratulations, everybody. You too gave it your all, and now you're high school graduates. And that's no small feat. If you're like me, I'm sure there were plenty of days when you didn't necessarily feel like going to school. Maybe you had a big test you weren't prepared for, a nasty pimple right in the middle of your forehead that just wouldn't go away. Or maybe you were just sick and tired of getting up for school at the crack of dawn, in the dark, 20 below outside, waiting on the bus, or walking in the cold. When I think back to my high school graduation from this very school, sure, it was an exciting time of transition, friends getting ready to go off to college, work, or take some time off, but it was also kind of disorienting, too. I had major worries on my mind. Do I have what it takes? Will I make new friends? What if I get lost at my new college? But you all have far more serious questions at hand. At a time when you should be celebrating graduation with all your friends, dancing, screaming, hugging, jumping up and down all together, and without a care in the world, you've been thrown a curveball. I don't need to recap the past few months for you because you've been living it. Online learning, social distancing, the fear of catching COVID-19 or losing a loved one. And as if worries about your future academic career or finding a job weren't enough to keep you awake at night, now you've got to deal with what about the future of this country? Will things ever get back to the way things were before I had to wash my hands 50 times a day for 20 seconds singing the Twinkle Twinkle song to keep count? Well, I'm here to tell you that yes, we are going to make it through this. Not only that, but I'm banking on us coming together, coming out the other side of this pandemic even stronger as a country and a society than ever before. I think that for all the negative stuff that this period in our history has shown us, from shortages of face masks, gloves, and testing kits, to political finger-pointing, name-calling, and in some cases even violence, there's also been a world of good out there. Where I live, in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, we've got restaurant chefs raising money and providing meals at no cost for their colleagues and their families who are out of work. And right here in La Crosse, the community response to this pandemic has been incredible. You're finding creative solutions to things like social distancing. Look at what's going on at the Parenting Place with programs like Muscles in Motion for little kids, streaming movement games on Facebook like Red Light, Green Light, and the Not Too Spooky Campfire Stories, encouraging families to camp out in their own yards. They're reaching hundreds of children and their parents every week online. Then there are just everyday folks, like the seamstress lady on the block, who makes face masks and hangs them on the back fence for anyone to have. The neighbors down the road who leave encouraging messages in their front yards, like, "We're going to be okay." And the elderly gentleman who gives free accordion concerts on his front porch. And there, you know, I got to say, I'm not so sure that's such a good thing. I mean, there was a bumper sticker once that read, "Play the accordion, go to jail, that's the law." I'm just saying. And how about the Beer by Bike Brigade? 350 people strong, raising money to provide free meals to those in need. Or the kind-hearted folks all over town filling up little libraries with canned goods. Yes, I'm not going to lie to you. This is a difficult time. But life is full of twists and turns. Having to respond to new, unforeseen circumstances can be very unsettling, even frightening at times. But in the long term, it can also make you stronger and more confident. Life has certainly thrown me a few curves along the way. Thankfully, my time here at Central, Lincoln Junior High before that, and Emerson Elementary before that, laid the foundation for me to navigate my way through. I'm a radio reporter today, but when I was your age, all I wanted to do was hit tennis balls, play the clarinet, and hang out with my friends. I played on the La Crosse High tennis team, in the wind ensemble, jazz band, and La Crosse Symphony. Full clarinet geek confession, I used to sneak down the hall into the band room rather than wrestling for basketballs in the gym during our lunch breaks and practice my scales. I actually wound up majoring in clarinet performance, won an audition after college, and played in orchestras for several years. But then came twist number one. An old junior high school football injury led to jaw surgery in college. More surgery later as a professional clarinetist in an orchestra, and poof. After 25 years, I had to give up the instrument and the career I loved and find another way to support myself. I moved to Austin, Texas. Years of prank phone calling when I was in junior high trained me well for my second career, telephone salesman. I was really good at it, but unfortunately the company turned out to be corrupt, and so I quit. Twist and turn number two, tennis. After all, I had been Three Rivers champion back in the day. Why not get certified and work as a tennis teaching pro? It was awesome. Until that second Texas summer rolled around, 5 weeks in a row of humid 100 degree days, 120 degrees on the asphalt courts, I quickly burned out. Twist number three, teaching clarinet lessons to 67 middle school students. Then classical radio announcer, producer, and just when management at my radio station was paving the way to make me full-time, another twist and turn, 9/11. The funding for my show was cut, sending me to work managing a youth orchestra, classical radio hosting at WFDD in Winston-Salem, and later executive producing an arts interview program there. And when the station shifted from a music format to NPR News, life's countless twists and turns and a great La Crosse Public Schools education had prepared me well. I could produce, I could announce, I could conduct interviews, teach, and be creative. I adapted and became a general assignment reporter. My stories have been broadcast all across the country, and I love my work. So you see, change can be good. That long and winding career journey all began for me right where you are today at Central High School. It's a very special place with teachers and administrators who really care about you. I remember many times when I had given up on myself, completely dejected, when a teacher stepped in to say, "No, David, you got this." And what a difference it made to me. I also know what a difference it makes to teachers when you stay in touch after graduation. For them, it means the world. And I can tell you from experience that even years from now, a phone call, email, or text, letting your teacher know what a difference he or she made in your life is not only meaningful to that person you're honoring, showing appreciation like that can be transformative for you too. If you're lucky, you made a close friend or two in school and went through a lot together. Now that you're graduating, without that daily or weekly connection you had at high school, it may feel strange when months or even years go by without speaking with your old pals. But trust me on this one. Do what you can to stay in touch. You'll be glad you did. 2 summers ago, I was back in La Crosse for a big reunion with old friends of mine and their families. We had all played in jazz bands together here at Central, and our old Lincoln Junior High band director, Tom Burkadall, had us all over for a jam session and dinner at his house. I got up to give a toast to thank Tom for introducing me to the clarinet, connecting me with some of my closest friends in the band, and in so many ways, setting me on my life's course. I'll be honest with you, I got about 3 sentences in before breaking down into a pool of tears and blubbering like a baby. But everyone there got it. They understood. Staying in touch with your teachers and friends and watching their children grow into adulthood is indescribably cool and something I hope each of you will get to experience one day. Central High School is and always has been a special place, loaded with tons of great memories, laughs, accomplishments large and small, moments that may change you in ways you don't even know yet. Take pride in your time here. Enjoy looking back. Appreciate the friends, family, teachers, and mentors who helped you arrive at this moment. Honor those relationships, but also know that this moment is just the beginning. Central is the foundation for your life going forward, not drifting back. I know that this is a very challenging time with an uncertain future. Maybe you're wondering if years from now you'll look back on your earlier time here and think, those were the best days of my life. Well, I'm here to tell you, no, that's not what your teachers want for you. And I know that's not what Principal McDonald wants for you. Yes. Congratulations, La Crosse Central High School Class of 2020, for making it this far. Just know that life gets better, deeper, richer. And all the academic, athletic, extracurricular work you've done in school for more than a decade leading up to this day, and all the experiences you've shared along the way have given you the tools you'll need to face life's many twists and turns. You got this.
Dear Class 2020, I'm sorry for things that have planned and had to be canceled. I wish everything could get back to normal. Like our boys basketball team, we were just 1 win away from making it to state for the 4th straight year. I wish we had done that. Also, I'm hoping that we still have graduation parties this summer. Mine is gonna be really fun. We're having a Nerf War tournament and it's gonna be really amazing.
Hello, Class of 2020. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Simone Toribio. Well, through all of the trials and tribulations, it looks like we made it. It might look miles away from what we all envisioned, but here we are at graduation. Here we all are virtually gathered together to celebrate one of the greatest milestones of our lifetimes. Amidst all the craziness and uncertainty in the world, I think it's important for us to continue being steadfast and to keep looking forward to the futures we've envisioned for ourselves, as we also take this time to reflect back on what we have learned. From what we learned in class to what we learned about ourselves, high school was truly a time filled with discovery. For me, I want to take this time to talk about a value that I have learned about in high school. A value that has grown in importance to me, and a value that, as current events continue to unfold, seems to be ever more needed in our world, compassion. Now, of all the different values to talk about, why compassion? Well, for me, it's a value that has grown in importance to me over my high school career. So what does it mean to be compassionate, and why is it important to our futures? Well, perhaps I should start on a more personal level. For those of you who know me well, you know I hold 2 important key rules or tenets close to my heart. 1, don't hold grudges, and 2, don't talk negatively behind people's backs. These rules have been created through my bonds with other people. I think one of the most important things we get from high school are these bonds we form with other people. Friends, family, coworkers, it doesn't matter who they are, we meet all sorts of different people with a variety of interests, backgrounds, and beliefs. Through my time in various leadership positions, as well as my time in debate, I have learned so much about so many different people. It's this new perspective which led me to creating these new rules. Sometimes you may not get off on the right foot. Maybe it's something they do that irritates you, or maybe something they believe in just doesn't seem right. However, if there's one thing that I've clearly seen, it's how pushing away and spiting those who you don't disagree with or just don't like only hurts everyone involved and only leads to pushing the situation to a spiraling abyss of hatred and negativity. I have found that the most effective, yet probably hardest way to heal these divides is to try your hardest to put aside your negative views of these people and to try and truly understand who they are as people and their differences with you. Our differences don't push us apart, but rather provide us avenues to learn about the world and thus come together as a more cohesive community. My one hope for all of you is that you remember to try and truly understand people on your journeys as you continue on to the next stage of your life. Now, as we expand our scope to the greater world, the need for compassion seems to be ever growing. As the coronavirus crisis continues to unfold, we have seen how bonds and connections between our global community have been broken or damaged. It seems as if everyone's out to get each other. It seems as if everyone has shut themselves into these exclusive groups that don't know what other people are doing or why they believe what they believe. It seems as if lines have been drawn, weapons have been raised, and it seems as if the world sometimes is descending into a state of violence and chaos. However, it's amidst this chaos where I believe we come in. We, the class of 2020, will be entering this deeply divided and complex world. We will have the power to shape the world in some way, whether it be global or local, through our interactions with people. My one hope for us and for our generation is that we go out there and try to heal these broken bonds. I hope that all of you somehow heal relationships, that you cross lines, that you mend relationships, and that you somehow bring the community together through building compassion in the spaces we are in. My one hope for everybody is that we don't throw away our shot and we help bring the world together through positivity and compassion. That is my one hope for us. Now, speaking of compassion, I want to take this last bit of time to share it with those who have made our journeys possible. I want to thank the teachers, school staff, and coaches who worked tirelessly to better us both in our studies and in our character. I want to thank all the family members that support us through whatever we're going through and help develop us as people. I also want to thank the friends that give us the support we need to get through. Truly, our lives would not be the same if it were not for the people we have bonded with. And as our time as high schoolers nears its final minutes, I just want all of you to remember to simply be compassionate to those you meet on your journeys as we all take our next step in the rest of our lives. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Abby Hilby, and I want to start off by saying I am so proud of you all. Congratulations, class of 2020. High school is quite the experience, but it's one we will all treasure because of the memories we've created, the lessons we've learned, and the fist bumps we've received. Shout out to Mr. McDonald. But as you all know, high school is not all glamour. Some parts of high school we wish we could forget, like the time Mr. Axness stepped into DJ Homecoming. No offense, but you can't listen to Fergalicious more than once. Before I get ahead of myself, let's start at the beginning. Freshman year, the first year of high school. For some of us, it was terrifying, and for others, it was just another day. We walked into Central with new shoes, new clothes, and a new school to navigate. When I was a freshman, I had a hard time getting to classes, but I came to this conclusion that Central is mainly a square, and if I kept walking, eventually I would make it somewhere. Which, okay, that's a decent strategy, but in under 5 minutes? Probably not. So I started asking people for assistance. The upperclassmen and staff were both happy to help. Personally, I wouldn't use that technique in college, but I do believe that when things get tough, if you keep a cool head and continue on, you'll make it. Sophomore year, we all began feeling comfortable and familiar with Central, and we were obviously thankful to no longer be freshmen. Now, sophomore year is a special year because we turn the golden age of 16. Ah, yes, getting our driver's license, which meant car keys on our lanyards. We saw them as our most prized possessions, and our parents saw them as their worst nightmare.
You know the feeling, walking into class with your keys in one hand and probably coffee or McDonald's in the other. Sure, you looked and felt amazing, but the worst part was waking up at the crack of dawn and driving 2 blocks to school just to park 3 blocks away. There was a point in time where many of us just decided to walk or ride a bike. Ava Shively, how's it going? Parking inconveniences aside, we made it to the slippery slope of junior year. We were warned by the seniors, but we ignored their remarks because we were excited to be upperclassmen. The ACT kept us awake most nights, and our other homework assignments put us asleep on the others. When it was almost time to take the ACT, the nerves arose and we began asking ourselves, did I study enough? We were all anxious when suddenly, polar vortex. Our saving grace arose out of nowhere. We realized that maybe we wouldn't have to take the ACT after all. Our hopes were quickly shut down after we were told the ACT would still happen. We spent our weekends visiting different colleges, or if you were like me, you went on the same college tour 4 different times. As juniors, we found ourselves a little more, and we also found the importance of community. At Central, every teacher was willing to help us, whether that was studying for the ACT or recommending us majors or certain colleges to check out. The hospitality found at Central is what helped us through the year, and when I look back on it, I couldn't be more grateful. The staff of Central saw us working hard, and they supported and guided us through it all. Now, junior year wasn't all bad. We finally got the privilege to go to prom, we didn't lose Olympic week, and we got to enjoy the second row of the student section. There was a lot to learn from junior year, but what stuck with me the most is that hard work is the root of success. If you put your best effort into everything you do, you will find success. It doesn't always come easy, and when you find frustration, realize there are people willing to help you. Well, we made it. Senior year, this is it. Our last year of high school, and it'll be unforgettable in ways we never expected. The year started off with a slight snowstorm at our homecoming game. Of course, the seniors knew what had to be done. Obviously, we had to blast Mistletoe by Justin Bieber. But senior year is not all fun and games. We are applying to colleges, taking core classes, doing scholarship essays, and much more. This year, I spent the most time in the library getting applications I had printed. And I must say, the location of the printer is a great view of the TikTok studio, which, by the way, is located in the left corner of the library. Besides making TikToks, we spent the year sleeping in, thanks to our releases, and we lived off the delicacy of the Uncrustables from the lunchroom. Throughout the year, we were bombarded with questions about our future, and we had to make the decision on where we would attend college. It was so exciting looking ahead and seeing what's next for us. However, such a big change seemed scary to some of us. But this is the class of 2020, and we have seen it all. We have faced some of the biggest changes, and we always found ways to adapt. I think the world thinks we're pretty tough. I mean, our freshman year, we had clowns roaming our nation, and our senior year, a pandemic is sweeping the world. We didn't let that stop us. We're here right now, and we're graduating. Change is inevitable, and we must embrace the change and cherish every second we have in life. Class of 2020, we have been so fortunate to have the teachers and staff on our side these last 4 years. From all of us, I would like to thank those who inspire us and keep us going every day. Thank you to Mr. McDonald and the Central staff for guiding us through our journey of high school. Thank you to all of our families and friends for the endless support. Once again, I am so proud of all of you, and I wish you the best as you start this new chapter in your life. It has been a pleasure to be a part of the class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I am so very proud of you. You will always be special to me in many ways. We started our journey together at Central. Your freshman year was my first year as principal. I think we were both confused and wondering exactly how this would go. But I hope that you've enjoyed your time at Central, and I hope that you're taking away with you prized memories of friends, peers, and staff that have helped you to grow as a person. I would like to thank the staff, who are a part of the best staff that I know. We have a staff that truly cares about students and do whatever it takes to help their students succeed. It shows in their actions each and every day that they come to work. Thank you, staff. It is impossible not to acknowledge all that this pandemic has taken away from you. So many wonderful experiences. The last month or two is truly the best time as a senior, and it's a time to take a victory lap for so many. But you've not had that opportunity. You are the first class to not have a prom and a traditional graduation at the end of the school year. You have my condolences for these missed experiences. If you think back to the very first day of your freshman year, I stated that I wanted you to enjoy your high school career. But if high school is the best time of your life, you are absolutely doing it wrong. It is my dream that you will have so many wonderful experiences in front of you that this will only be a blip that you will talk about in the future. One of the celebrations that was canceled was the All-School Awards Night. This is a special night to recognize the students for all their hard work and what they've done during this year. One of the awards that is presented is the Senior Student of the Year. Two students are chosen for this award. This year's students are Anna Durrell and Simone Toribio. Congratulations, Simone and Anna. You are the best of the best. Your generation is the best group of young adults that we have ever had. It is tougher to get into the school of your choice, and you do get caught when you make mistakes, thanks to cameras and social media. You're expected to show leadership and compassion. Your generation is more kind and compassionate than any generation of students before. What does this mean? It means that you give me hope each and every day that our world will get better and that you will be the reason for this. Two things that I wish for you as a class and as individuals are to have a clear image of who you want to become. When you're in high school, it is easy to get caught up in who you have been for the past 13 years. In my 32 years as an educator, my biggest frustration is listening to young adults who are not able to focus on the amazing talents that they possess. They focus on their weaknesses and their shortcomings and how people look at them. This limits you in so many ways. I want you to see who you want to become and make choices and decisions based on who that person is. You have the right to be the person you are meant to be. I hope that you have perspective and see what is truly important and what is not. Perspective is a very challenging concept. I will make you a promise that a pimple for a big event is not really the worst thing that will ever happen to you. Perspective is knowing the value of loved ones in your life. Don't be shy and letting the special people in your life know how important they are and what they mean to you. The most amazing musician to date is Bruce Springsteen. This is not a discussion. This is a fact. Bruce performed a special performance at Carnegie Hall. It was recorded and turned into a televised event. And one of his quotes really struck me. He said, "There are things that I miss about being young. The thing I miss the most is the blank page. Young people are able to write their page about what they will become." I also had an opportunity to listen to Coach Mike Krzyzewski, the men's basketball coach at Duke University. And he spoke about how everybody is running their own race. He spoke about the fact that it's a different race. And as you go out and write this story, don't worry about what others are doing. Focus on your race and where you're going. Be happy for others as they accomplish great things and keep moving forward. It doesn't matter how fast you are, but it does matter that you believe in yourself and that you keep moving forward. Your future is not written. I know that you are going to write something amazing and awe-inspiring, because you are amazing and awe-inspiring. I look forward to following your progress and seeing the amazing things that you will accomplish. A lot has been made about you are the first class born after 9/11, but I'm going to guess most of you don't remember much of this event. I'm sure that you will remember the pandemic of 2020. You're a part of history, good or bad, but this will not define you. You are a class that has fought against climate change, that has come together to recognize a fallen classmate who touched so many. And you supported your peers as they have dealt with the challenges of the many facets of this pandemic. You are stronger than any pandemic. You are going to persevere, and you will succeed. The Central High School staff would like to congratulate you and thank you for the 4 years that we have spent together. I recognize this is not an ideal ending that you had hoped for, but remember, high school is not the best time of your life. You have so much to look forward to, so good luck on your next journey. I wish you the best, and please know that I care, and please know that you are going to be okay. Congratulations, class of 2020. It is now time to present the class of 2020. As principal of Central High School, it is my duty and privilege to certify this class for graduation. Superintendent Nelson, I can verify that these seniors have met the requirements of the La Crosse School Board and the State of Wisconsin for a high school diploma, and therefore I recommend that they be graduated.
Will the class of 2020 please stand? To signify that we have graduated, would you please move your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left side? As class president, I present the La Crosse Central High School's graduating class of 2020.